Let's say the two voltage levels we are using are plus 5 volts for logic 1 and minus 5 volts for logic 0. While transmission, let's say the plus 5 volt comes down to 2 volts due to the attenuation which is taking place, and minus 5 volts comes down to minus 2 volts due to the attenuation. Now, if you do not modify or if you do not correct this new voltage levels, then this attenuation may keep on increasing. And it may happen that by the time signal reaches to the receiver side, the signal is greatly attenuated, the voltage levels have gone down to zero. Or it may also happen that the noise which gets added to my signal when it transmitted through the channel, this noise which can have positive negative spikes may also affect the voltage levels of the signal. So let's say, for example, the voltage level which has come down to 2 volts can now be sent back to 5 volts simply because something which is positive value must represent the positive level of plus 5. The only two levels in the signal that we have are plus 5 volts and minus 5 volts. So if the signal value at some point of time is minus 2 volts, that means it has to be minus 5 volts which has come down to minus 2 volts. So the repeater can take a corrective decision by sending it back to minus 5. So we can use a threshold value of 0 and say that anything which is greater than 0 should be sent back to plus 5 volts, and anything which is below 0 should be sent back to minus 5 volts. This way, regenerative repeaters can help us to restore the original levels of the signal and reduce the amount of noise. Now, we talked about the sampling process in the PCM. We all know that sampling process must take place according to the sampling theorem. The sampling theorem says that FS has to be greater than equal to twice FM for a low pass signal. If FS is not less than twice FM, then as we have discussed before, the aliasing will take place, which is a kind of a distortion in the signal. Now, let us say we have a sampler which is using the sampling frequency of 10 kilohertz, for example. Now, if FS is 10 kilohertz, it is very important that the value of FM is not greater than 5K. It has to be less than 5K, because if at all, let's say FM is 5 kilohertz, with FM equal to 5K, FS has to be greater than equal to 10 kilohertz. And because the sampling frequency we are using is just 10 kilohertz, we will be able to avoid aliasing. Any value of FM in the input signal which is greater than 5K will undergo the aliasing error. And hence, we use a low pass filter to make sure that no input frequency is greater than 5K. The low pass filter will have its cutoff frequency set to 5 kilohertz. It will remove any frequency which is greater than 5 kilohertz in the input signal. And hence, the input signal will be bound between 0 to 5 kilohertz. And hence, FS value, which is equal to 10 kilohertz, will become the valid sampling frequency. Hence, we can say that this filter is used to avoid the aliasing, and hence, sometimes it is also called anti-aliasing filter. So, that's about the transmitter of PCM. Let's now go through the receiver. In the receiver of pulse code modulation, just to ensure that the incoming signal has only one of the two defined levels, plus 5 volts and minus 5 volts, we use right in the beginning a regenerative circuit which is similar to the regenerative repeaters which we deploy in the channel at periodic distances. This regenerative circuit will work exactly in similar way that we discussed before. You can take 0 volts as a threshold. Anything above 0 volts should be sent back to plus 5 volts. Below 0 volts should be sent back to minus 5 volts. Decoder will carry out the inverse operation of encoder. That means it will generate the signal which will be represented in the form of discrete sample values. If you remember, the input of the quantizer was the sample values which were taking any possible value in the signal, but output of the quantizer was the sample values converted to some fixed levels. So those fixed levels will be represented in terms of the original values using decoder. Once we get the output of the decoder, it will be similar to an analog signal, but every sample value will be having a fixed value and it will not be a smooth waveform which will resemble to the original signal. Once we pass it through a reconstruction filter will be similar to a low pass filter. It will smoothen the signal. It will remove all the high frequency components from the signal, and output of the filter will be very much similar to the original analog signal that we have. Destination can be any output device. To to which the reconstructed signal will be given to.